Hey, everybody. Thanks for tuning in to the new whiteboard series from The Virtual Strategist. My name is Erica Olson. I'm the CEO of On Strategy. I'm so glad you're here. We're talking about building responsible AI in organizations. And this video is one of four parts that specifically helps you put a policy in place to have responsible AI in your org and with your team. This video is on building a learning hub as part of your responsible AI policy. The other videos covered governance structure, super important, as well as building guiding principles, and to start with, an overview of the whole thing. So check those out if you haven't already. And do not skip this one, because AI is all about continuous learning and continuous improvement and continuous innovation. So you know, in order to make your organization ingest AI as part of your DNA, it needs to have a hub of learning. So let's jump into the whiteboard and talk about how to set yours up. So setting up a learning hub has three parts. We always like three parts. It keeps it easy and simple. This whiteboard, again, is set up to help you facilitate a conversation with your team, or figure it out yourself and then talk to your team about it. But it's really structured to build it with your team. So first things first are, you know, why do we need one, actually? And I think that that is important to get aligned on. So one of the things that we've noticed a lot when it comes to AI deployment in organizations is there's a lot of siloed efforts. And in order to move fast, and this is about moving fast, smart and fast. In order to move fast, we need to stop the silos. We got to learn from each other. And we need to be intentional and prescriptive about that. We leaders need to be intentional and prescriptive about that. And again, I already said that too, because you need to iterate and learn and adapt faster. You also want to make sure that you're on top of potential emerging risks. So that's another reason to kind of have a hub of coming together to make sure that you're starting to see a risks that you might not be thinking about right now as they're starting to pop up again, because this is such a new field of play, so to speak, for so many organizations. Yep, I talked about preventing duplicative efforts. We want a space for innovation, so we want to encourage innovation. And there is just so much going on and so many ideas to share. When we start to create momentum with AI, the momentum creates more momentum, and that's really what you want. It also really helps people get out of maybe a place of feeling scared about this technology. So once you've agreed on the why and everybody's convinced and committed, it doesn't need to be heavy. Learning hubs can be asynchronous and synchronous. Asynchronous meaning in a virtual capacity and in channels, right? Slack channels, Teams channels, and also synchronous coming together. So let's talk about your channels. And it would be important to decide where are you going to centralize the information and the learning. So a lot of organizations have SharePoint sites set up that will host your guiding principles, that will post your governance structure, post your AI committee members, and set up some thoughts and guidelines around how to create and innovate either in a Teams channel, maybe it's a Slack channel, or maybe it's another set of tools that you're using, which is where you come together, but it's dedicated. And then of course, how you use it is always super important. You know, where do ideas go versus projects, so on and so forth. And then another thing that would be important to articulate is the idea that certain projects need to come forward to be shared, reviewed, and learnings captured and published. And so depending upon how the AI, your AI committee that you established because you listened to the last video, depending upon the scope of your AI committee, that AI committee may just be a centralizing committee to shepherd and champion AI, in which case they don't have authority to say yes or no to projects, but rather they can come together to review and pull learnings so that you're starting to share things out into the broader org. That committee also might actually be an approval committee, in which case maybe some projects do come forward for review. But the point on this is just to say, when you're setting up a learning hub, consider two things. One is that you've got asynchronous channels set up, so people can participate when they want to and how they want to. And number two, you have a live place, could be virtual, but a live place to come to talk about projects, review projects, and share learnings. In addition to that, it's always helpful to set up a really simple communications matrix so your committee, who will be shepherding all of this, knows who to communicate to and when. Again, we don't need to overdo it, but we do need to be intentional. So this is a pretty simple communications matrix where you would identify your audience, all staff, maybe when you're going to roll out certain aspects of maybe the learning hub, maybe it's guiding principles, whatever it is, what is the and how. So this is the channel, like how, right? And when. Ongoing communication, how and when. And then the preferred method, it's covered up by my video, but please know this is intended to be the communication tool, right? So if this is email, maybe it's an all staff meeting, maybe it's part of the CEO weekly debrief, whatever that happens to be. So again, just listing all the audiences, this says all staff is one of them, all the audiences, when you're rolling stuff out, how you're going to communicate ongoing, and then what's the tool that you're going to use to execute that communication. Again, just want to really say we don't need to overdo it, but we do need to lightly make sure there's clarity on how your team comes together and how your organization comes together to learn from each other so that you can iterate, learn, and adapt faster. So with that, that's the last part of putting together your responsible AI policy. And you'll have everything you need so that AI becomes part of your organization and part of your DNA, and you do it safely and smartly, and quite frankly, have some fun with it. So with that, if you want to use our live and editable whiteboards, click on the link on the screen and you'll get access to the Miro boards. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. We're dropping videos often about this subject and others. Thank you so much for tuning in. Happy strategizing.